officially vote, accept, reject, or whatever, Mr. Levitt's letter, we will comment. The chairman is elected by the entire community, still serves as a spokesman for this group. And I said, I have 2 months to serve, and I will serve those 2 months. One last thing I want to say is last Friday, I received a formal complaint from a member of the MWA board that suggested four other members may be operating outside the scope permitted by MWA bylaws. More specifically, these four members may be in violation of the Georgia Open Meetings Act by holding a number of private meetings outside of approved MWA board committee meetings. And two, are constantly involved with employees in the day-to-day operation without the knowledge and permission of the executive director, the president. I'm also concerned about the above violation and one more, that these same four are involved in the discipline and termination of MWA employees that have resulted in a loss of leadership and especially minority leadership in top positions. Continuation of this behavior will erode the integrity of this organization and risk wasting ratepayers' money on wrongful termination suits and settlements. Since the board cannot self-investigate, I'm contacting the Macon Judicial Circuit District Attorney and the Chief Judge of the Superior Court of Bibb County for advice and possible investigation. I want to do everything possible to restore the integrity of this organization and alleviate any fears that employees might operate